Marriage Mart by Kelly Kirch. Copyright 2008. Printed by Resplendence Publishing, LLC. Chapter 1. Poppycock, Lady Esther Richmond announced. After all, what was one to say to such a thing anyway? Three girls considered her with ill-disguised interest. Pish-posh, Esther declared to the silent trio. Esther rolled her eyes, looking at each of her friends in turn. Marie, fair-haired and owner of exquisite china-blue eyes, blinked slowly even as her lips twitched with mirth. Penelope, blonde as well, only ashy, widened her hazel eyes in prudish surprise. Esther turned her attention to the final member of their party. Carolyn's gaze didn't waver from Esther's, as though ascertaining whether Esther truly did mean to think that marriage was unnecessary, or if she was once again trying to shock them with her free-thinking ways. Esther sighed with exasperation. We're pawns. Our fathers arrange a suitable match, and we are expected to bow to those wishes with the remaining years of our lives. What if I dislike Mr. Welby above all else? I have yet to meet the man, and father is set to read the banns himself. What if you do like him, Essie? Reasoned Marie. Yes, agreed Penelope. Mother says she came to care for father once she knew him better. Perhaps you will as well. If I go to London for a season and meet this Mr. Welby fellow, my father will think I have come to an understanding. I won't do it, Esther warmed to her argument. She could discover that she liked Mr. Welby, but as yet she had no information on the man. Ignorance did not sit well with her. It smacked of blind acceptance. You're quiet, Carolyn. What do you think? Carolyn tapped her lip with her forefinger. I think you will do as you deem fit and confound your father for it. I think you really mean to ask. Is what is to be done? Esther beamed at her. Precisely. Then yours is a very different question. I think we have to consider your father's request. Carolyn held her hand up to stay Esther's retort. While satisfying your requirements, do you detest the idea of marriage, or are you rebelling against your father's decision? I suppose I'll marry you someday, Esther said, but only to a man I choose who allows me my freedoms. The three friends nodded their agreement. Then we compromise, Carolyn reasoned. Penelope glanced from one lady to the next. Esther cannot disobey her father. He wouldn't choose a poor match for her. So we agree, returned Marie, with impish grin, teasing a dimple from her right cheek. We'll join you in London, as your father allowed. While we're there, she nodded to Esther, we will find Mr. Welby and discover his character to your satisfaction. Then we can dissuade him from a suit if you don't care for him. If you decide to carry on with the wedding, your father will be more than pleased. If you decide to cry off, she turned to Penelope, we will give him to Penelope, who cares not for love. Marie winked at Penelope. Penelope's shocked gasp. I jest, Penny, Esther giggled. Aren't you clever, Marie? But I may have to add my own condition to the plan. I must be certain Mr. Welby's the man of character my father expects. Beginning of a plan tickled at the edges of her imagination. Marie leaned in, willingness to conspire in Esther's latest scheme evidenced in every fiber. Penelope glanced over her shoulder toward the closed door of the library. Carolyn folded her hands in her lap and waited. She cocked an eyebrow. We will do as Marie suggested, but with a slight difference. Esther's gaze darted between her friends. Penelope groaned. I'll go to the soirees. I'll dance at the balls. But I will go as a man. To purchase Marriage Mart by Kelly Kirch, please visit www.resplendencepublishing.com.